Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, we are from group 11, and here we are gonna present about our presentation, and our material is incomplete independent clauses. But before we start our presentation, let us introduce ourselves. My name is Ramadan Salasa Wandia.
Hello, my name is Muhammad Iqbal.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Let me introduce myself. My name is Agilanyus Perendeska.
Okay, let's start our presentation. The first one will be presented by Ahmad Lufi. For Ahmad Lufi, the time is yours.
Okay, friend. In this time, I will explain about clauses. Baiklah, saat ini saya akan menjelaskan tentang klausa. Clauses is a group of words that consists of a subject and a verb. Sometimes it makes sense as a complete thought and may stand as a sentence, but sometimes it doesn't. Klausa adalah kelompok kata yang terdiri dari sebuah kata subjek dan sebuah kata kerja. Terkadang, klausa bisa menjadi sebuah kalimat dan bisa juga tidak. Jadi, kalimat sudah pasti sebuah klausa, namun klausa belum tentu sebuah kalimat, bisa menjadi sebuah kalimat. Next, subject and verb. A subject is the person or thing that is doing something or being something. Subject adalah seseorang yang melakukan sesuatu atau menjadi sesuatu. The subject performs the verb. Subject adalah pelaku dari kata kerja. A verb is the action word in a sentence. Kata kerja adalah pekerjaan yang terdapat dalam kata sebuah kalimat. A verb can also describe a state, such as be, have, like, see, and others. For example, mom will be home soon. Sebagai contoh, ibu akan pulang segera. The subject of this sentence is mom, and the verb is be. Subject dari kalimat ini adalah mom, dan kata kerjanya ialah be. Sentences. A sentence is a group of words which communicate a complete thought or idea. The most basic sentence in English contains only a subject and a verb. Kata kalimat dalam bahasa Inggris biasanya hanya terdiri dari sebuah subjek dan sebuah kata kerja. A sentence may contain only a couple of words or can be longer and have a more complex construction. And this is when clauses may be used. Sebuah kalimat bisa terdiri dari beberapa kata atau lebih lanjutnya bisa terdiri dari konstruksi yang kompleks. Dan di saat inilah klausa digunakan. All sentences consist of one or more clauses. A simple sentence consists of one clause. Seluruh kalimat mengandung klausa. Dan di pada kalimat simple mengandung satu klausa. Example. People need vitamins. Orang memerlukan vitamin. Pada kalimat ini, subjeknya ialah people dan verbnya ialah need. Next, Toby lives in Washington. Toby as the subject, lives as the verb. Pada kalimat ini, Toby adalah sebagai subjek dan lives sebagai verb. Contoh lainnya ialah I will go to school this morning. Dalam kalimat ini subjeknya ialah I dan the kata kerjanya ialah go. Selanjutnya ialah independent clauses. An independent clauses is a group of related words that contains a subject and a verb and expresses a complete thought. Sebuah independent clause adalah kelompok kata yang terdiri dari kata subjek dan kata kerja dan mengekspresikan sebuah ide yang komplit. Selanjutnya akan dijelaskan oleh teman saya, Agil.
Thanks for a chance, Ahmad Rukbi. I will continue this materi. And before that, I'll introduce myself first. I'm Agil Inspirenska from Group 11. And like what he say about independent clause, last materi he present before, I will repeat that materi first before I continue to the my materi. Yes, like was you all heard from him, independent clause is a group of related words that contain a subject and a verb and express a complete thought. Here I make an example from that. I have for example 1. I picked a flower for you. It was independent clause. And like I was explained for you all before, independent clause contain a subject and a verb and express a complete thought. And in this sentence, I figured a flower for you have that all. I as subject figured a flower as verb and for you complete the sentence. Example number 2. My mom is nice. Once again, my mom is nice. This sentence, same like I was said before, like I figured a flower for you. This is independent clause. My mom as subject and is as verb. Nice, complete the sentence. Number 3, the teacher taught me how to read. Once again, the teacher taught me how to read. The teacher is as subject and taught me as verb. You know how to read? Definitely complete the sentence again, like before. Like my mom is nice and I figured a flower for you. And last example about independent clause, the woman sang. Once again, woman sang. The woman as subject and sang as verb. That's complete. It's all. That's all about independent clause. Next, I'll explain about dependent clause. Yes. Alright. Dependent clause contain a subject and a verb. But the difference here between dependent clause and independent clause is dependent clause do not express a complete thought. Dependent clause do not express a complete thought. A dependent clause is not a complete sentence like independent clause. Is not a complete sentence. Once again, a dependent clause is not a complete sentence. Example: If mom is nice, cause here terdapat kata if, maka kalimat ini menjadi kalimat dependent clause karena if di sini menjadi kata penghubung di depan daripada suatu kalimat. Kedua, while my teacher taught me to read. While my teacher taught me to read. Di sini while berperan sama seperti if di atas. Dan terakhir, because the woman sang. Peran because di sini sama seperti while dan if sebelumnya. Menjadikan sebuah kalimat dependent clause. Sorry, independent clause menjadi kalimat dependent clause. Dengan mereka berada di depan kalimat tersebut. Dan sebelum itu saya akan mengasih sedikit materi lagi sebelum teman saya yang akan melanjutkannya, yaitu tentang that was about dependent marker word, that the important thing in the dependent clause and independent clause materi. Dependent clause usually start with a dependent marker word. A dependent marker word is a word added to the beginning of an independent clause to make it dependent. A dependent marker word added to the beginning of independent clause to make it dependent. Example, I have example here. I like flower. Now, let's turn it into a dependent clause. Why? How? We can turn it independent clause to the dependent clause by adding word here, such as because. Because I like flower. That dependent that independent clause before now was transferred into the dependent clause by adding because in that sentence. Next, I will explain to you all sedikit lagi. The above group of words does not communicate a complete thought and become a dependent clause. The dependent clause must be connected with an independent clause to make a complete sentence. I have example here. I have two independent clause. First I have two independent clause, and the one tetap independent clause, and the another one I change or I transform into the dependent clause by adding because. I will spell that sentence. First independent clause is I planted flower. I planted flowers. The another one is I like flowers. And this sentence I like flowers, I adding because word in the front of sentence. And that sentence now be like because I like flowers. Because I like flowers. And the another one sentence is the independent clause was I planted flowers. I repeat the explain from my explaining before. The dependent clause must be connected with an independent clause to make a complete sentence. Here we have one independent clause and one dependent clause. I planted flower and because I like flower. And we connect the that too. And after we connect, the sentence be like, I planted flower because I like flower. That was complete sentence. That's all about, sorry, that's all about dependent marker words. And here, I have to tell you all, to sharing for you all, but some common dependent marker word, like after, although, as if, because, before, even if, even though, if, in order to, since, though, unless, until. That's all from me, and the next present will presented by Muhammad Iqbal. Thank you.
Okay guys, I will explain about compound sentence. Compound sentence consists of two independent clauses joined by a coordination like such and as and but. Compound sentence terdiri dari dua clause independent yang digabungkan dengan konjungsi koordinasi seperti such, as, and, dan, but. Permulanya adalah clause plus coordination conjunction plus clause. Here I will show the example. The first is the man took a vitamin pill and he drank a glass of mango juice. Di sini kalimat konjungsi yang digunakan adalah and. Dan untuk kalimat the man took a vitamin pill itu merupakan clause-nya. Dan yang clause yang keduanya adalah he drank a glass of mango juice. The example number 2, Andre lives in Nottingham, Philadelphia, but she was raised in Brazil. Kalimat konjungsi yang digunakan di sini adalah but, dan untuk kalimat clause yang pertama adalah Andre lives in Nottingham, Philadelphia, dan untuk kalimat she was raised in Brazil itu merupakan clause yang kedua. Oke, selanjutnya kita akan membahas complex sentence atau kalimat complex. A complex sentence consists of a independent clause and dependent clause. Subordinate clause may be adverb clause, noun clause, or adjective clause that also joined by subordinate conjunction like when, how, where, why, if, although, unless, since, because, until, so, as. Rumusnya di sini adalah independent clause atau main clause plus subordinate conjunction plus subordinate adverb atau noun atau adjective clause. Baiklah, di sini saya akan menampilkan contohnya atau example. Contoh yang pertama adalah kalimat ini. He told him that she did not play again over a moon. Di sini bisa kita lihat kata that di sana adalah subordinate conjunction atau kalimat yang menghubungkan kalimat kompleks tersebut. Untuk kalimat he told him itu merupakan main clause atau independent clause-nya. Dan yang kalimat yang she did not play again over a month itu merupakan subordinate adverb. Complement is a word or group of words that complete the meaning of the subject, verb, or object. Thus, three kinds of complement. There are subject, verb, and object Komplement. Komplement maksudnya adalah kata atau kumpulan kata yang melengkapi arti dari subjek, verb, dan objek. Jadi ada tiga macam pelengkap, yaitu subjek, verb, and object complement. Di sini kita lihat complement. Yang pertama subjek complement. Di subjek complement di sini untuk mendescribe the subject atau yang menjelaskan subjeknya itu sendiri. Yang kedua adalah verb complement. Itu adalah objek dari kata-kata tersebut atau is an object of a verb. Yang ketiga adalah object complement, itu definisi objek atau yang mendefinisikan objek tersebut.
Okay, thank you Iqbal. Next, I'm gonna explain you about subject complement. So, what's subject complement? Subject complement is a noun, pronoun, adjective, or other construction, acts as a noun or adjective that follows the verbs of being or linking verbs, and the function is to explain or refer to the subject of the sentence. Jadi, apa itu subject complement? Subject complement adalah kata benda, kata ganti, ataupun kata sifat, atau benda bentuk lainnya, yang berperan sebagai kata benda maupun kata sifat, yang mengikuti kata kerja being, ataupun linking verbs. Dan fungsinya adalah untuk menjelaskan subjek dari kalimat tersebut. Linking verbs can be verbs of sensation. For example, feel, look, smell, sound, and taste. Linking verbs itu ada dua bentuk, yaitu kata kerja mental, yang contohnya seperti merasakan, melihat, mencium, dan mendengar. And verb of being, for example, act, appear, be, become, continue, grow, prove, remain, seem, and turn. Dan lagi ada kata kerja dalam bentuk aksi, seperti melakukan, muncul, menjadi, melanjutkan, menumbuhkan, membuktikan, dan masih banyak lagi. There are two kinds of subject complement. There are predicative adjective and predicative nominative. Ada banyak sekali bentuk dalam subject complement. Yang pertama itu adalah predicative adjective dan predicative nominative.
Alright, I gonna show you the example. The first one. Mr. Mamat was a great headmaster. In here, headmaster is a predicate noun.
Jadi, kita ada contoh pertama di sini. Mr. Mamat adalah kepala sekolah yang hebat. Kita lihat kata headmaster. Headmaster di sini berperan sebagai predicate noun, yang mana headmaster itu menjelaskan dari subjeknya, yaitu Mr. Mamat. And the second one, that lady is very beautiful. Beautiful is a predicative adjective. Jadi, di sini kita lihat kata beautiful. Beautiful berperan sebagai predicative adjective, yang mana kata beautiful ataupun cantik itu menjelaskan dari subjeknya, yaitu that lady. And the third one, the noodle tastes delicious. Delicious is a predicative adjective. Lalu yang ketiga, mie ini sangatlah enak. Kita lihat kata delicious di sini. Delicious berperan sebagai predicative adjective. Dan delicious di sini menjelaskan dari subjek kalimat tersebut, yang mana subjek di sini adalah mie alias the noodle. Jadi, mie ini sangatlah enak. Okay, next, I'm gonna explain you about verb complement. So, what is verb complement? Verb complement is the direct object and indirect object of a verb. These objects can be in the form of nouns, pronouns, or other constructions that act like nouns. For example, gerund, infinitive, and noun clause. Jadi, apa itu verb complement? Verb complement adalah direct object ataupun indirect object dari sebuah kata kerja ataupun dari suatu kata kerja. Objek ini bisa dalam banyak sekali bentuk, seperti kata benda, kata ganti, ataupun dalam bentuk lainnya yang berperan sebagai kata benda. Seperti contohnya ada gerund, infinitive, and noun clause. Okay, in here I gonna show you the example. For the first one, my boss paid me $2,000. Di sini kita melihat contoh pertama. Bos saya, pembayar saya $2,000. Yang di mana kata me di sini berperan sebagai kata ganti ataupun pronoun, dan $2,000 di sini berperan sebagai noun phrase. Dan yang kedua, and the second one is I love swimming. The swimming is Jerun. Dan yang kedua ini artinya adalah saya suka sekali berenang. Yang mana kata swimming di sini dalam bentuk Jerun. Jerun itu artinya verb ditambah dengan verb ing. Next, the third one. The third one is she wanted to go. In here, to go means infinitive. Dan yang ketiga adalah dia ingin pergi. Yang mana to go di sini berperan sebagai infinitive. And the fourth, he discovered that creating a website is quite easy. That creating a website is quite easy becomes noun clauses. Okay, yang keempat adalah dia menyadari bahwa membuat website itu sangatlah mudah. Yang mana kata that creating a website is quite easy itu berperan sebagai noun clauses. Okay, the last one. The last one is object complement. So, what is subject complement? Object complement is a noun, pronoun, adjective, or other construction that acts like a noun or adjective that describes or refers to a direct object. Only transitive verbs can have object complement. Apart from describing the object of verb, this object can also follow the object of preposition. Jadi, apa itu object complement? Object complement adalah kata benda, kata ganti, ataupun kata sifat, dan dalam bentuk lainnya yang berperan sebagai kata benda ataupun kata sifat yang menjelaskan kepada direct object ataupun objek langsung. Jadi hanya transitive verbs yang boleh memiliki object complement. Tetapi selain itu, selain mendeskripsikan object of verb, objek ini bisa mengikuti object of preposition ataupun kata depan. Okay, let me show you the example. The first one, I found the question easy. In here, easy as adjective is the complement object of the question. Okay, yang pertama adalah saya pikir pertanyaan itu mudah. Yang mana kata easy di sini menerangkan tentang kata dari question yang berperan sebagai objek di sini. Jadi artinya di sini adalah saya pikir pertanyaan itu mudah. Nah, kata mudah di sini menerangkan dari objeknya, yaitu question. And the second one, nobody calls him nice. In here, nice as adjective is the complement object of him. Yang kedua artinya adalah tidak ada yang memanggil dia baik, pikir dia baik. Yang di mana baik di sini menerangkan tentang him. Tetapi ada kata nobody di awal, jadi tidak ada yang berpikir, tidak ada orang yang memanggil dia baik. Jadi di sini him ini bermakna negatif, jadi dia itu tidak baik. Jadi kata nice di sini menjelaskan kata him yang artinya tidak baik. Okay, this is the end of our presentation. I hope you guys enjoy our presentation, and I hope that our presentation will be useful to you who wants to learn about incomplete independent clauses and the missing of subject, verbs, and object complements. Okay, I think that's all from us. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.